Okay, hope all of you understood regarding about respiratory volumes. Now we are going to discuss about respiratory capacities. So by adding up a few respiratory volumes described above, one can derive various pulmonary capacities which can be used in clinical diagnosis. So by the adding up few respiratory volumes, by the adding up respiratory volumes, the describe of respiratory capacities is takes place, pulmonary capacities is takes place, and which is used in clinical diagnosis. So any person is suffering with any type of respiratory disorders, so easily the person can be identified by the values of respiratory volumes and respiratory capacities. Okay, how respiratory capacity came, that given here, by the adding up of a few respiratory volumes only. Okay, let us see what is respiratory capacities. What are respiratory capacities? Respiratory capacities are inspiratory capacities, IC, expiratory capacity, EC, functional residual capacity, FRC, vital capacity, VC, total lung capacity, TLC. Inspiratory capacity, IC, and expiratory capacity, EC, functional residual capacity, FRC, and vital capacity, VC, and total lung capacity, that is TLC. So let us discuss first one, inspiratory capacity, that is IC. So the definition, go through the definition of IC. The total volume of air a person can inspire after a normal expiration. The total volume of air a person can inspire after normal expiration. So here capacities was explained. So capacities means what? How much volume of air a person can inhale and exhale? What is the capacity, respiratory capacity of the person? So here the total volume of air a person can inspire after normal expiration is called inspiratory capacity. So this includes tidal volume and inspiratory reserve volume. Just go through the graph, you can easily understand. So what is the normal inspiration point? This is the normal inspiration point. So this is the normal inspiration point. This is normal inspiration point, and this is normal expiration point. This is normal inspiration. This one is normal inspiration. This is normal expiration. Normal inspiration, normal expiration. So what is the definition? The total volume of air a person can inspire after a normal expiration. So what is the normal expiration point? This is the normal expiration point, right? So the total volume of air, the total volume of air a person can inspire after normal expiration. So from this point, how much volume of air a person can able to inhale? A person can able to inhale from here to here. Here to here, what? That is TV, by the normal inspiration. The person is able to inhale additional volume of air also. What is additional volume of air? IRV. This extra volume of air also a person can inhale, right? So this is called inspiratory capacity. The total volume of air a person can inhale after normal expiration, from normal expiration point to maximum inspiration point. Okay, right. So IC is equal to, this is what? TV plus, this is what? Already we discussed in earlier graph, that is IRV. From here to here, what is that? IRV. So IC is equal to TV plus IRV. Up to this clear? So what is the value of TV? 500 ml plus, what is the value of IRV? 500 plus 2500 to 3000. So IC is equal to 3000 to 3500. This is inspiratory capacity. Understood or not? Right. Next one. So that one only given here. This includes tidal volume and inspiratory reservoir volume. So IC is equal to TV plus IRV. Okay, right. So next one, expiratory capacity. The total volume of air a person can expire after normal inspiration. Total volume of air a person can expire after normal inspiration is called expiratory capacity. The total volume of air a person can inspire, a person can expire after a normal inspiration. So what is the normal inspiration point? The normal inspiratory point is, this is normal inspiratory point, okay? This one is normal inspiratory point. The total volume of air a person can expire by normal expiration, right? So the total volume of air a person can expire after normal inspiration. After normal inspiration, what is the normal inspiration point? This is the normal inspiration point. So from this point, how much volume of air a person can expire from normal inspiration to normal expiration means TV the person can expire, and from normal expiration point to how much the person is going to be expires up to maximum expiration. This is the maximum expiration point. So here given, see, so this indicates from here to here, this indicates what? EC, expiratory capacity. The volume of air, the total volume of air a person can expire after normal inspiration. By normal inspiration, a person is going to be expires TV, and the person is going to be expires extra additional volume of air also, that is ERV. So this is called EC, expiratory capacity. So EC is equal to TV plus ERV. IC is equal to TV plus IRV. EC is equal to TV plus ERV. So what is the value of TV? 500 ml. What is the value of ERV? That is 1000 to 1100 ml. So 500 plus 1000 to 1100 ml. So that is called as EC, expiratory capacity. Up to this clear, all of you? Okay. So next one, functional residual capacity. Functional residual capacity, FRC. Volume of air that will remain in the lungs after normal expiration. The volume of air that will remain in the lungs after a normal expiration. After normal expiration, what is the normal expiration point? This is the normal expiration point. So the volume of air remaining in the lungs, presented in the lungs, not inhale, not exhale. The volume of air, the total volume of air presented in the lungs after normal expiration is called functional residual capacity, that is FRC. So what is normal expiration point? This is normal expiration point. After normal expiration point, how much volume of air presented inside the lungs? After normal expiration point, the volume of air presented in the lungs is, that is, per person is forcibly expires the volume, additional volume, that is ERV, and the minimum volume of air presented inside the lungs, that is RV. So FRC is equal to ERV plus RV. Understood or not? By the normal expiration point, at the normal expiration point, how much volume of air presented inside the lungs? The minimum volume of air presented inside the lungs, this is RV, okay, this one clear? And remaining additional volume of air also presented inside the lungs by forcible expiration, that is IRV. So FRC is equal to ERV plus RV. So that is only given here. The volume of air that will remain in the lungs after a normal expiration. This is the normal expiration point in the graph. What is normal expiration point? This is normal expiration point. So from normal expiration point, in the time, how much volume of air presented in the lungs. So ERV also presented and